Hello everyone, Buzzkiller here, and welcome back to the channel. Now tonight, that's May 19th, 2016, CIG has finally released Alpha 2.4 to the public test universe. Now as you may know, over the past few weeks, the game has been in the hands of the Evocati, which is the pre-PTU testing group, and I've been part of that group, but unfortunately, I have been underneath an NDA, so I have not been able to release any videos or any screenshots, nothing from the patch until today, which they finally lifted the NDA, and they're giving it to the first wave of normal testers. So there are a ton of changes in this patch. 2.4 is huge. It's the biggest patch since 2.0. And while I'd love to sit here and tell you everything that's new about it, that video would just be, it'd be at least an hour long. So in this first video, what I'm going to do is just take a look at the two new ships in the game. The first is, of course, the Hangar Ready Reliant Core, which we're looking at right now. And the other is the Starfarer Gemini, and I'll show you that here in just a moment. These will be pretty short because the Reliant Core is a pretty small ship. It shouldn't take too long to go through. And the Starfarer Gemini, well, you've seen the Starfarer, and there's not a whole lot of differences. I'll just go over and hit some of the major differences. So let's start off taking a look at the Reliant Core here. Now, the Reliant Core is the standard cargo variant of the Reliant series. And as such, it is not very well armed. For weapons, it comes with two sized 1 fixed M3A laser cannons. There's one on the wing there. And these little blue dots you see are part of the port mod system, which have replaced the holo table. So unfortunately, I can't get rid of those. So you just have to bear with me. But that's how you change stuff on the ship. And in fact, I'll go ahead and demonstrate here. Well, let me stand up. It's easier to see when you're standing. There we go. When you click on those port mods, it brings up a list of weapons you can place on there. And of course, these are all size 1 weapons because that is a size 1 port. So a nice little addition. There's still some bugs with this new system that need to be worked out. There's some weapons that you can't access, like the weapons on top of a constellation, etc. But we're not going to talk about that here. Let me continue on the ship tour. Now, as I said, it has the two size 1 fixed weapons. It's supposed to have a size 3 gimbal mount as well that has a small ball turret with two more, either size 1 or size 2. I believe it's size 2 weapons on it. Unfortunately, that is not on, but I believe it would go here on this port. It says there's nothing equipped here right now. But I believe it's on one of these ports that size 3 or gimbal will fit. Just looking at the ship, though, itself, it's a good-looking ship. It's not very long. I think it's only 13 meters long. But, man, it's wide. It's got to be at least 30 meters wide. And, of course, it has that bulbous canopy. Very, very nice. I like the shapes to it. It has some interesting shapes in the glass. This huge antenna of some sort. It might be a fueling probe. It could be some kind of sensor. Looks like a headlight there on the front. And maybe a spotlight and some running lights, possibly. But of course, this ship, when it takes off, it is supposed to go vertical. Right now it's in landing configuration. I don't know if the wings are supposed to fold like in the concept art. But it's not folded in the hangar. But the engines are facing down, unfortunately, so because we can't really take a look inside of those. Some very interesting looking engines. And then on the rear, here's our first MISC logo. As you know, MISC loves to brand their ships, so we'll be seeing a lot of those. Now, one thing I like about the rear, it kind of looks like it has tail lights, like on a car, pretty cool looking, actually. I don't know if those are supposed to be countermeasure launchers or what, but they kind of look like taillights. I kind of like it. Take a nice close look at the landing gear. Just let me go into a prone. Very nicely detailed landing gear. Small, but it's a small ship. Can I see some dad plates up in there? Another running light. And of course, the bare aluminum metal that MISC is known for. There are a few dings on it here and there. But again, this is a cargo ship. Very nice looking. Now on the wings here, you have your maneuvering thrusters. And this is a set of, I believe, 4 maneuvering thrusters. On each, you have one on the top, one on the bottom, but I think they're fixed. They might rotate, but there's a thruster pointing directly down. There's a thruster pointing to the rear, to the front, and outboard. I don't think there's one. No, there's not one pointing inboard. Very cool. Now the 3 points in here, I believe these are your shields, coolers, and what was the other thing? Shield, cooler, and power plant. Now the stats on the page say that it has a size 3 shield and a size 2 power plant, but of course that's changing, so it's probably going to be 3 light components, 3 small components, so the new size 1. Let's go ahead and enter the ship, and that is done from the rear. Watch this animation. It's pretty nice. We go. And you enter directly from the rear, and here is your cargo area. Let me crouch down. The lighting's a little wonky in here. Let's try to get a place where I can look up, but you can see there's more MISC logos. Close that. Hardware panel of some sort right there. Fire extinguisher. This is very similar to the back of the Freelancer with the cargo netting. And of course your cargo mag locks. Now this thing has supposed to have a cargo capacity of 30 SCU. I'm not sure if that's accurate, but I'll just go with it for now. Of course all stats are subject to change. As we move forward into the neck, you've got some access points for various equipment. So if you're doing repairs, probably could access your power supply and your coolers from here. Got some more of these orange pipes, kind of like in the Starfarer. Of course, more MISC logos there. And it looks like another access panel on the ceiling. Again, that lighting's a little annoying. Looks like we might have some kind of personal storage on the bottom, maybe tools. And of course the rubber mat with the thousands of MISC logos on it. I swear, MISC. Processor access panel, mirrored text. It's probably your ship avionics. There's the right way around it. Of course these really cool chairs. They're on the swivels. When the ship goes vertical, they will turn as well. And of course, the left is the pilot seat, and the right is the co-pilot seat. You might notice I'm also wearing civilian clothes, so that's pretty nice. Let's go ahead and jump in. Another MISC logo in the backrest. Oh, I just noticed the material on that seat. We'll have to take a look at that here in a moment. Before we do, let's go ahead and go into a third person and do a fly around of the ship. That's about as close as I can get. There you can see more of those maneuvering thrusters with 4 nozzles each. I'm not sure if those vents in the rear are supposed to be thrusters as well or just part of cooling. I don't know, but your main engines, of course, swivel backwards. And then that center section for the cargo will stay level as the wings spin around it. There's some more vents in front of the engines. I'm not sure what those are for. And the Ace of Clubs logo. I'm not sure what that's all about either. There's another nice close look of the landing gear. Pretty cool. Let's take a look inside the engine. As best we can, anyway. Very nice. It looks like those fins may articulate a bit. Some nice curved lines under here. Access panels, rivets. All the detail CIG is well known for. Very cool looking. I never noticed this before. Some kind of intake there. Top and bottom. It almost has that Star Wars pod racer vibe to it. Let's go ahead and jump back into first person and look around here. And look at this view. Man. See, up until now, all the MISC ships we've seen are larger cargo vessels. This is a smaller vessel, and wow. This ship is supposed to have the most Xion technology of any MISC ship, and you can kind of see it in the shape of that canopy. It kind of resembles the hamster ball from the Cartual. There's another panel up there. A little bit of Z fighting on the buttons. Wow. Really nice. Nice dual stick setup for controls. Let's go ahead and jump out. Just want to take a quick look at the material of this seat. Looks almost like a denim. Got the little leather side bolsters. And that blue, the dark blue, looks almost like a denim. The light blue, it's like a felt or cloth. Nice little orange stitching in the leather. Really cool. Really, that's about all we can really look at in this ship. Some kind of manual control. The co-pilot seat's not really very interesting. It's look pretty much the same as the other. It just has, instead of pedals there, it has a single footrest, and you just sort of sit there. I think it's going to have a holographic display and some different displays up there. It's not worth sitting in there. I think it's about time to move on to the Gemini. Another nice thing about the new port system is you can spawn and despawn your ships from in the hangar. And that's done by finding the correct port mod, clicking it. I'm gonna go ahead and remove the client here. And I need to find the correct port mod for the Starfarer. I don't think that's it, but let's check. Oh, this is the right one. And let's pull up the Starfarer Gemini. It says item pending. That's because we need to get out of the way before it spawns. And there she is. Now there's, I think, probably three main visual differences between the Gemini and the standard Starfarer. The one is, of course, that military green paint job. It looks pretty good. A little bit matte. But I don't know. I kind of prefer the aluminum of the standard Starfarer. But I understand what they're doing. They're giving a military vibe with the matte green paint. Another difference is the front fuel scoop has been replaced by a missile launcher. And I believe those are size 3 missiles there. And of course, you have 9 of them. And they're pretty powerful. The underside here, it looks like it has a targeting system. Almost looks like something off an Apache gunship. Probably for those missiles. Of course, you have your standard weapons. These combine ballistic cannons now have exploding projectiles. When they fire, they're like flat cannons. They explode and they cause massive damage. I mean, they're really powerful. You knock out pirates around the comma rays really quick with these. One shot them, they're gone. Very subdued with that paint. Now, the other difference visually are the engines. These are supposed to have bigger engines, and they have some slightly different shrouds. The front of the shroud's different from the Starfarer, and the exit nozzles are different as well. The exit nozzles kind of look like the ones from the Retaliator. Of course, this is the Aegis rebuild of the ship, and the Retaliator's Aegis, so it's got some similar nozzles to the Retaliator. Give it a little bit of that Aegis vibe, Aegis aesthetic. Other than that, pretty much everything is the same as the standard Starfarer. It's got all the same tanks, and one thing that surprised me is the cargo hold is actually the same as well. The only difference in the interior between this and the Starfarer right now are some of the paint. This floor is orange in the standard Starfarer, whereas in the Gemini, you can see the green pipes as well. In the Gemini, it's green. A lot of green inside, carrying forward that military theme. I think the weapons are supposed to be a little bit better on the ship, but so far I think it has the same weapons. Of course, this room in the Starfarer is all orange. Again, I kind of like the original Starfarer look on the interior paint, but I understand what they're trying to do here. Whoop! I fell through some geometry there, but that's okay. Really wasn't anything new back there to look at anyway. Let's go ahead and walk up to the crew quarters. I'll take the shortcut here. The final difference between Starfarer and the Gemini is the bed. They've taken away our Whoopi. The captain's Whoopi is gone. He's now stuck with just an olive drab army blanket. Oh boy. Oh well. I think these panels are different color as well. They're green instead of blue. But of course, those are just placeholders anyway. Yeah, just about everything else is the same. I wonder if I can get up in the turret here. I can. Move the turret though. Go ahead and take a look around. You can see more of the UEE paint job. Some of the self-lighting on the top. There's another look at those Retaliator-style engines. Yeah. But that's about it. I think we can go ahead and close off this video. You've seen the new Starfarer, Gemini. You've seen the Reliant Core. And I will be giving the Reliant Core away once it becomes flight ready. I want to do a flight test on it and do my review. And once that's done, at the end of that video is where I will take the entries for the giveaway. So we're getting pretty close to 25,000 or 2,500 subscribers. So that'd be a nice little thank you for you guys on top of course, the original giveaway was originally just a giveaway because of the Gladius you guys got me from the referral program. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I will continue making some 2.4 videos for you covering this ship in flight. Yes, it is flight ready, as well as a Starfarer, and covering some of the differences and some of the major changes in 2.4. So stay tuned for those. And until next time, this has been Buzzkiller, and I'll see you guys in the verse.